tree. He'll shelter himself from the shade of that tree. He'll drink from the water of that tree. And he thinks that no one had deserved or earned what he earned. And then Allah Azza wa Jal will plant another tree closer to the paradise. And the gates of the paradise much higher and nicer tree than the tree that he's in, with nicer water next to it. So he says, "Ya Allah, make me get under that tree. To be under that tree and drink from the water of that tree." So Allah will tell him, "Oh my servant, didn't you say you're not going to ask me anything else?" So he says, "Ya Allah, I promise you I would not ask anything after that." So he'll go under that tree and he'll drink from the water of that tree. So he sees the paradise. So he'll say, "Ya Allah, let me enter the paradise." So Allah Azza wa Jalla will tell him, "Didn't you say you're not going to ask me anymore?" So he says, "Ya Allah, I would not ask you anything after that." So Allah will tell him, "Wouldn't you accept to have what the king of the kings of this world had in this world?" So he'll say, "Yes, Ya Allah." So Allah will tell him, "I'll give you 5 times over that." So he'll say, "Yes, Ya Allah." Allah will tell him, "I'll give you twice as much as that. Go to the paradise." So enter the paradise. Go to the paradise. And he thinks that no one got what he got. He thinks that he's the best man. And that's the worst man, you could say. And that's the last man that comes out of the hellfire. The last man to enter the paradise. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, that Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah Azza wa Jal, Almighty and Glory, will bring the most richest and wealthiest and luxurious man in this world. And Allah Azza wa Jal will dip him one dip in the hellfire. Allah will bring the richest, the most wealthiest, the man that had all the luxury, the man that had all his desires fulfilled. Allah will bring him and he'll dip him one dip, 1 second in the hellfire. And then Allah will ask him, "Oh my servant, oh my servant, have you ever experienced luxury before? Have you ever experienced happiness before?" After that 1 second, he forgot every single happiness and every single luxury he had in this world. So say, "No, Ya Allah, I haven't." 1 second. 1 second in the hellfire made him forget every single happiness, every single time and moment of happiness he had in this world. 1 second, one dip in the hellfire made him forget every single wealth he had in this world. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord, will bring the most poorest man in this world, the most miskin man in this world. Allah Azza wa Jal will bring the man that faced all the hardships and calamities in this world. And Allah Azza wa Jal will bring him. And Allah will dip him one dip in the paradise. 1 second in the paradise. Allah will dip the most poorest man in this world one dip in the paradise. 1 second. And after, Allah Azza wa Jal will bring him. And Allah will ask him, "Oh my servant, have you ever experienced poverty before? Have you ever experienced hardships before?" So he replied to Allah, after all those years of hardships and poverty, after that 1 second in the paradise, one dip in the paradise, "No, Ya Allah, I have not experienced no poverty before. No, Ya Allah, I have not experienced no hardships in my lives before." So that 1 second in the paradise made him forget all his hardships in this world. That 1 second in the paradise made him forget all his hardships in this world. But subhanallah, to enter the paradise is not easy. And to enter the hellfire is very easy. Because sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, حُفَّتِ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِهِ وَحُفَّتِ النَّارِ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. That the paradise is surrounded with the hardships. And the hellfire is surrounded with desires. If you want to enter the paradise, you must go through hardships. If you want to enter the hellfire, you follow your desires. If you want to end up in the paradise, you must struggle. You must go through the hardships. You must pray. You must fast. You must do what Allah wants you to do. You must obey Allah. You must stop your desires from what He wants and do what Allah wants you to do.
It's hardships. That's how you enter the parables. If you want to enter the hellfire, follow your desires. Whatever your desire tells you to do, do. Whatever your desire calls you to do, do. Whatever comes to your mind, do. Whatever you feel like, do. Whatever your emotion wants you to do, do. That's how you enter the hellfire. حفت الجنة بالمكاره وحفت النار بالشهوات. The paradise is surrounded with hardships. You want to enter the paradise, you must struggle.